find myself wondering what the world must have been like before the bear crashed into our frail planet, transforming all we once knew into a colorful kaleidoscope of delicious chaos, and I love it. The world was more hospitable, no doubt, more orderly, more sensibly sickening because it sounded boring, and I hate being bored. I can't imagine a world without the bear. Or the storms, yes, the storms. Beautiful waves of emerald blood cry down from the heavens, promising death in lawless disarray, constantly upsetting the order. I get butterflies in my tummy just thinking about it. Death. Yes! Speaking of which... Let's see... Oh, it's Horatio, the humble blueberry farmer, loving father, and the most boring creature on the face of this planet. But what's this? Looks like you've got a spicy situation on your hands, Well, it's been nice knowing you, Horatio, not really, but now it's time for you to die, yes. How exciting! Not for you, of course.
Staying
awake,
you too!
Horatio dies. Blueberries and a stupid look on his face, Horatio set out to find some shelter, burdened with the realization that none of this would have happened had he listened. And to make matters worse, he's got weak arms and he's not all that handsome. I don't see what all the fuss is about, but all of this will haunt him until I decide to end his misery. What fun. A beautiful lady. She looked hungry. Horatio shared his blueberries.
Hell, I know you got it.
No, you shared your berries.
Huh?
How generous of you.
How did you
her
win?
Name was Pipistrella, and though she looked more than capable, she requested Horatio's aid. You see, her castle was raided by grumpy warriors, and she doesn't like that very much. Go on, my little hero. Perhaps this could become a mutually beneficial relationship. The one with the mustache told me you guys are stupid and weak. I don't know why he'd say that. Chaotic job, gentlemen. Go wreak havoc elsewhere. Oh, sorry, Pip. Are you upset? With her castle in ruins and a very dead daddy, Pipistrella accompanies Captain Worthless, and what a woman. Her optimistic outlook and reckless bravery captivated Horatio. So much, in fact, that he immediately forgot about his son and his home and... Yes, you did. I see. Horatio gave Pipistrella the remainder of his blueberries, and they headed for the city. The perfect place to recuperate and make plans for Horatio's inevitable failure and death. Plus, there's a pretty good restaurant there that has great beef stew and Yes, the city! How it bustles with excitement! Keep your wallet in your front pocket. Thank you. had won the battle, Horatio kissed Joseph on the lips and then stabbed him in the stomach. Now, you really should listen to me, Horatio.
Wonka Wonky Nong. Snocky pocky, but stoody doo, linky winky, binky bong bong, lost nana, and tonky wonka wonky nong. How about you?
truck might step out and try to wiggle.
Oh, yeah,
now
we die.
You want me?
Thank you for playing. Now go away. No way. Stay. It's only fair to prepare you for what's to come. You'll find yourself in the city, maybe with a friend, maybe inside your precious little house, customizing your team's looks and strategies. Then it's off you pop to the market to purchase, I don't know, dainty dresses for all your warriors, so they look pretty as little peaches as they prance from epic quest to epic quest, laughing and eating cake, meeting new heroes, getting stronger, maybe getting a little too arrogant because it's all in vain. And at the end of the day, you're all my precious little puppets, and we're going to have some fun. See you soon.